Yes, sir. What is going on, YouTube? It is your boy, Denali, a.k.a. Don Squally. Back at it, I guess, with another Forza Horizon 3 build video, man. If you guys tuned in to our last Tanner Fox Ford Raptor build, man, you guys will know that we got an overwhelming amount of requests for yet again another Tanner Fox build. Now, I'm going to run through the list real quick here. I'm going to try to keep it as quick as possible. We do have quite a few people on today's request. Uzair Charles, John Gimpon, Jobin21, Paradox Ducky, Jonesy Jones, George Ramos, Tanner Baker, Jaden Rosemay, Logan Hendra, Aiden29, Kyle S, Zach Sloan, Randy Swinarine, Maxime LeBlanc, Devoidus Benavicious, and Pack Ultra all want to see that Tanner Fox Speed Society R35 giveaway build, man. Now, you guys know how we do it when the people rally together as much as you guys did on this request, man. We got to go ahead and make this one a reality. So what we're going to do, obviously, jump into the buy car section, into the Nissan area of the vehicles here, and we are going to go ahead and buy a GTR from scratch and see if we can make this happen. Now, what we have here are a few different options: the GTR Black Edition 2012 or the 2017. Now, I'm going to go ahead and pick the 2012 just because I believe this is the body style that they are rocking with, not the newer 2017 style. There's a lot of really unique parts on this car that I think we're really going to have a fun time building this one. So we're going to go ahead and start out with this plain white GTR just to keep things simple. And now that we own our GTR, we are just about ready to hit that upgrade section, man. So obviously we're going to start out with some custom upgrades. Now we are looking for right around 800 horsepower. Like I said, a ton of parts on this car. And we're just going to go through the list here, try to pick off as many different ones as we can. Now with the front end, this thing looks like it doesn't have an aggressive splitter, but it does have a rather aggressive front lip slash bumper on this thing. So I think we're going to have to go ahead and throw that Forza lip on here, even though this car does not have canards. Now, as far as the rear wing goes, I think we're probably going to go with that LB Works, man. That actually, you know what? No, that's the swan neck. We're going to go with the plain Forza wing on this one because, you know, I am going to try to get this one as close as I possibly can. Now, this thing is rocking a nice set of Michelin Sport Cup 2s. So, for us, that is going to equal a race tire compound. We are also going to go ahead and widen up those tires because once we start feeding this thing a little bit of horsepower, I got a funny feeling it's going to be a little tough getting that power to the ground. Now, as far as the wheels go, I'm going to take my time and try to find something that is almost identical to what Tanner and Speed Society has done to these GTR wheels. So I'm just going to skim through a few of my options here. Now, obviously, we cannot find the exact wheel, but I think I am going to go with these ADV ones. I think they're going to be pretty much identical, the closest match that we're going to get on this one. So we're going to go ahead and install those real quick. Now, this thing is rocking a set of 20-inch tires, but because I want a nice beefy look on the rims, I'm going to go ahead and upgrade these to a 21-inch. Now, I'm going to go ahead and leave the transmission stock. Don't think they would have upgraded that, but we are going to get into a couple of the other upgrades here. Obviously, starting out with the big brake kit. That is something that I feel we're really going to need once we get out there, start unleashing a whole ton of horsepower. I think that's really going to help. Now, everything else, we're just going to keep pretty much basic, no weight reduction on this thing. But now comes the fun part. Now, this thing is rocking a Cobb carbon fiber intake, upgraded Cobb fuel injectors, that Fabworks 4-inch exhaust, which is absolutely insane for a car like this. No cams on this bad boy, but that block is pretty well built, so we're just going to go ahead, do the valves on this thing, as well as the pistons and compression. obviously has those bigger turbo inlets as well as the downpipes, upgraded intercooler, as well as that oil catch can. And we're going to go ahead and upgrade the flywheel. Now, it looks like we are well over 800 horsepower with this build. So I'm just going to dial it back slightly. Where we want to be is right around 595 horsepower. So I'm going to take the turbos back one stage. And with that said, I think we are just about ready to move on to the next step in this build, which obviously is going to be the tuning. Now, we're not going to get too carried away here because, I mean, this thing is a GTR, and let's be honest here, folks. This thing's probably pretty close to as perfect as it's going to get from the factory. Now, obviously, there are a lot of improvements to be made, but the GTR overall, such a refined car that I don't really feel the need to mess around with too much in the tuning section. Now, one thing that we do need to do is look up this Tanner Fox / Speed Society livery, man. So I'm going to go ahead and type in Tanner Fox first and foremost, see what pops up here. Now, as a lot of you guys know, there was the Tanner Fox Guaczilla as well as the pink GTR. So I'm expecting to see quite a few of those designs, but I am looking for that Speed Society livery wrap here. So I'm going to skim through a couple of my options and let you guys know when I find one that I like. Now, as I'm skimming through here, we are just getting way too many of the Guaczilla. So I think we're probably going to have to go back here and search for Speed Society and see if we can have any better luck here. And it looks like we only have one option here, which is going to kind of suck. There is a lot going on with this wrap, so I'm going to try to find I'm going to try to find another wrap here. Alrighty, so I am just having no luck here. So what I'm thinking we're probably going to do is have to go ahead and make this one ourselves, man. So first and foremost, we are going to have to paint this thing. And I mean, you know, as you guys can see, very bright red. So we're going to go ahead, paint that up. The wheels need to go 100% black as well as the windows here. Everything else looking pretty good so far. That wing, the wing can't be painted, so we're just going to go ahead and save it the way that it is. And then we are going to hit the apply decal section. Now, I am not going to go through too much detail in here just because I want to keep this video relatively short. So I'm just going to get at her, man. And when I get something that I like here, I'm going to show you guys what I come up with. Alrighty, and this is what I have come up with. Now, I did search up a couple of the designs, so I won't be able to share this. And unfortunately, I wasn't able to get that Michelin sticker on the front. But overall, I am super happy with how this turned out. So we're going to go ahead, save this to the current car. I'm expecting us to have too many save files. You know how it goes when you're Don Squally. Now that we got that out of the way, for real, we can take this thing out on the road and see what it's all about. Now, I am super excited to see what this bad boy can do. Obviously, GTRs, nothing to be messed with from factory, and right now we are rocking 800 insane horsepower, all-wheel drive, looking like those tires, those street tires, not really giving us a whole lot of traction on the off-road here, but I think once we get off the off-road is where this thing's really gonna shine. Now, I think for a from scratch build, this one turned out pretty good. Not too many pictures of this car online for me really to reference, but I think overall, aside from the banner on the windshield and that Michelin sticker up front, I think we got this one relatively close. You guys let me know what you think of this one. Having no problem reaching 300 kilometers an hour. Now, I know I get a lot of comments asking, how does this guy make his cars go 300 miles an hour? Well, I'm in Canada, so that's why I have my speedometer in kilometers, not miles. So you guys out there who are wondering why my cars are so fast, which hack am I using, man? It's that glitch where you just go and you change it from, miles to kilometers. Makes feel like you're going really, really fast, man. Now, this thing handling absolutely beautiful, tapping that red line just a little bit, but I mean, once you're on the road, brakes amazing, the handling is great, those tires just absolutely coming in clutch. I'm having trouble talking too much and not shifting the gears here, so I'm just going to continue on here. Love this road here coming along the side of the ocean, that nice little view happening. One of my favorite roads in Horizon 3. Now, Horizon 4 going to be coming out very soon. Had a couple people ask why I'm not playing The Crew 2. And I played a lot of different games aside from Horizon. And they just don't get nearly as many views as my Forza Horizon videos do. My Forza Motorsports videos, I'll be lucky if they break 1,000 views. And I was playing, I believe, The Crew, the first one. And just, you know, they weren't getting very many views. And for me to go out, buy a completely brand new game, start playing it, putting in the effort to make money in order to do these types of builds, you know, it just doesn't make sense when everybody just still loves Forza Horizon 3 so much. And, you know, I'm no exception to the rule. Forza Horizon, probably one of my favorite racing games ever. Now, when I first started out playing video games religiously on my Xbox, Test Drive Unlimited is where it was at. Now, back then, Forza only had circuit racing video games out. Horizon was not a thing, and I always said that if Forza came out with a game where it's free roam, just cruising around, plus they have the same customizability. Is that a word? Customizability. So we're going to make it a word today. If it had the same customization as it did with the actual track racing game, that it would be the best game ever, because Test Drive Unlimited was a good game, but as far as your mod options, and you know, you couldn't do wraps or anything like that, you couldn't put on different types of wheels, and you couldn't, like, you know, it was very basic as far as your mods went. Forza just absolutely killed it. And then Test Drive Unlimited 2 came out, and it wasn't built by this, like, the same manufacturer, didn't make the game, and the physics were not the same. So when Horizon came out, it pretty much is what made me start this channel, and then obviously is what grew the channel, because you guys watching those videos religiously, which I am, you know, I cannot say thank you enough to you guys, you know, brought this channel to where it is today. And now, I mean, over 50,000 subscribers, lots of loyal viewers. I see a lot of the same names on the channel doing requests, man. So big shout outs to all you mofos taking out the trees, doing a little bit of edging in the garden there before we park, and take our thumbnail for the end of this video. Now, I'm pretty happy with how this turned out. A few different things that we could possibly change, but nonetheless, it is a Speed Society Tanner Fox giveaway GTR, man. So if you guys did enjoy this video, don't forget to smash that like button. If you guys want to see more and you are not subscribed yet, you know where that subscribe button is, man. I ain't got to tell you anymore. As always, I'm your boy D Nolly, aka Don Squally, and we're gonna catch y'all mofos at the next one, man. Peace. Don't die. Oh shit, where you going, bro? Don't be creeping on my friend. Don't be creeping on my friend. You and your homie. Oh, nut shot. Nut shot. Oh, buddy. Let's go. And your boy, man. Get him out of here. Oh, fucking. Oh my God!